The way in which that love is wonderfully expressed is beautifully recorded in a letter that Paul once wrote to some folks living in Corinth. And I read to you a few verses that the seal was set, let it be set with these words in mind. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud. It is not rude, it is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered, it does not keep a record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with truth. It always protects, always trusts. Always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. It is the love of God in Christ, in and through and around, that never fails. Now I have the privilege of offering a few words of advice and encouragement, and at least I hope they will be of value to you and your children as you enter into the state of marriage. Now, you're going to be remembering this day, of course, May 5th. From now on, it's the anniversary of your wedding, but you'll never be celebrating it alone. There are millions of people to the south of us on El Cinco de Mayo who will be celebrating. And I mention this for a reason that will emerge later. Perhaps most of us north of the border don't fully understand what El Cinco de Mayo is all about, and I'm not going to go into any detail except in 1862, the Mexicans led by General Zaragoza were badly outnumbered by the French, but they won a wonderful victory, and so they have celebrated ever since. The 5th of May also is an important date in the history of the United States, at least those who were interested in the exploration of outer space, where it was on the 5th of May, 1961, that the first astronaut went into outer space. Remember, his name, first name actually was Alan Shepard, Jr. And it was a day filled with suspense, anticipation, and then excitement and celebration. It was only a suborbital flight, but it was the beginning of what would turn out to be an amazing series of events that would end up with a man on the moon in less than 10 years. Now, the name of that one-person space capsule was Freedom 7. And you are about to launch here into quite an adventure. And you do not have a one-person capsule. You have one that I think has space for, well, at least 7. Pilot, 2 co-pilots, and 4 crew. The crew being Chris and Brandon and Mackenzie and Holly. The co-pilots, Alan and Carol. And the pilot would be Jesus. Freedom 7 fits, ready to launch. So I have some advice for you. I'm going to give you a word here by which you can remember this piece of advice. There are actually 5 concepts that I'd like to impart to you very briefly, but each Each concept is tied to a word. The first word is Christ. Now, he really is needs to be the pilot. In each of your lives here, as this family is blended together, life is a challenge. We know that. And it's important to always keep Christ as the one who is in charge. You probably remember or have heard the WWJD little slogan there, "What would Jesus do?" Whenever things, you're not quite sure about what needs to happen next, just check with the pilot. If you're ever in a situation where you're thinking, Jesus is my co-pilot, change seats, put him in charge. That's the first concept. The second is tied to the word invest. Now, I want to give you a little advice here, not on how to invest money, but to invest something that is more important, more precious than that, which is time. Time is a commodity that is very precious. The pressures of jobs, even from the time you're old enough to kick a soccer ball, it is just, there are so many things that put demands on our time. So whatever else you do in managing your busy lives, I would say figure out how to invest time, husband and wife, as parents, with children, so that you have significant experiences together. That's an investment that pays terrific dividends. Third concept I want to tie to the word negotiate. Now, in a perfect world, there would be no need to negotiate. Everybody kind of knows what everybody else needs, and it works out smoothly. But you're all individuals and have your own needs and desires and wishes and wants and so on. So it's really important to agree here and now that you will always negotiate. Figure out a way for a win-win solution to whatever it is that's facing the six of you. Negotiate. The fourth concept is tied to the word celebrate. Now, it's good to celebrate anniversaries and celebrate birthdays and holidays, and but to think of other things for which you can celebrate, just have fun together, that's really it. So important for building your family together. And I would remind you, too, that that once a week routine at church is meant to be a celebration, to celebrate God's love for us and get our lives back on clearly on track if they're wobbling just a little ways off. And the last concept is tied to the word offer. Often is the answer to questions like, how frequently should you say you love each other? The answer, often. It's the answer to the question, how many times did you say, I'm sorry, please forgive me? Well, as often as it's necessary. How many times should you say affirming, encouraging, supportive words? Answer, often. Now, perhaps you've already figured out what the key word is to remember all of this. Because if you take the first letters of these words, Christ, invest, negotiate, celebrate, often, you have Cinco. Seemed appropriate thing on El Cinco de Mayo. And I thought, maybe just crazy enough that you will remember this. One added thing, since El Cinco de Mayo only comes once a year, and I would want you to be thinking about this more often than once a year, you do have a possibility of a little memory reminder in your kitchen. So frequently when you go into the kitchen and you see the sink, I want you to think, sink, oh! And even though it's not spelled the same, you'll think Cinco and can sort of review, how am I doing in terms of the concepts related to Christ, invest, negotiate, celebrate often. Freedom 7. Ready to launch? Vaya con Dios. Go with God. And now, I have a little traveling music. For the exchange of vows. Alan, if you take Carol's hands and repeat to her your wedding vow after me. I, Alan William, take you, Carol Ann. Carol Ann. To be my wedded wife. And I do promise and covenant before God and these witnesses to be your loving and faithful husband, in plenty and in want, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and in health, as long as we both shall live. Now, Carol, will you pledge your wedding vow? Repeat after me. I, Carol Ann, take you, Alan William, to be my wedded husband. I do promise and covenant before God and his witnesses to be your loving and faithful wife, in plenty and in want, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and in health, as long as we both shall live. Now, and what do you have to give as a sign and seal for the vow you? Carol, do you accept this ring?
Yes.
Then if you put this ring on Carol's finger, repeat after me. This ring I give you as a symbol of my love for you and as a sign that we now are one. And what do you have to give as a sign and seal of the vow you just made? Alan, do you accept this ring? Put this ring on Alan's finger, repeat after me. This ring I give you as a symbol of my love for you and as a sign that we now are one. Alan and Carol will now light the wedding candle, taking the light from the family candles that are there, and it's symbolic of their lives being united and blended together. Light and love of Christ. Christ. Following that, they have some special gifts to give to their children.
Kind friends all gathered round is something I would say, that what brings us together here is blessed us all today. Love has made a circle that holds us all inside. The strangers are as family, loneliness can't hide. You must give yourself to love, if love is what you're after. Open up your heart to the tears and laughter, and give yourself to love. I've walked these mountains in the rain. I've learned to love the wind. I've been up before the sunrise to watch the day begin. And I always knew I'd find you, though I never did know how. Been like sunshine on a cloudy day. Give yourself to love, if love is what you're after. Open up your heart to the tears and laughter, and give yourself to love. Give yourself to love. Love is born in fire, is planted like a seed. Love can't give you everything, but it gives you what you need. And love comes when you are ready. Love comes when you're afraid. It'll be your greatest teacher, the best friend you have made. You must give yourself to love, if love is what you're after. Open up your heart to the tears and laughter, and give yourself to love. Give yourself to love. You must give yourself to love, if love is what you're after. Open up your heart to the tears and laughter, and give yourself to love. Give yourself to love. You must give yourself to love, if love is what you're after. Open up your heart to the tears and laughter, and give yourself to love. Give yourself to love. You must give yourself to love. Give yourself to love.
Let us pray. Lord, we thank you to be here in this moment in time, celebrate this wedding, and to pray with Carol and Alan as they launch forth from this point in time. Pray first for thanksgiving for their loving parents, for the care and wisdom that they have shown to them in many different ways over many years, and for their siblings and friends, how important all these ties are, and often is at times such as these that we see and understand and appreciate in much deeper ways than ever. We do pray for them as whose lives join together. Pray not only for Carol and Alan, but Brandon and Chris and Holly and Mackenzie. Pray that it will be clear in each of their lives that Christ truly is the pilot. That you would help them in a world that is very demanding to invest time in each other. And using the qualities of love, which have been sung about today and read from your word, truly negotiates and create an atmosphere in which family is truly formed and strengthened by the ways of your love. Help them as well always to celebrate life, celebrate one another, and as regards communicating love, affirmation, acceptance, and the ability to say, I'm sorry when necessary, to do that as often as needed. Thank you, Lord, for your guidance, for the assurance of your presence, and the strength and wisdom that comes from being rooted in an eternal relationship with you. In Jesus' name, amen. Now by the authority which is given to me as a minister in the Church of Christ, I declare Alan William Ruff, Carol Ann Branke, you are now husband and wife according to the ordinances of God and the laws of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. Alan and Carol. God wants to bless and enrich your lives. You already have, you have four beautiful children, and a wonderful family. So much lies ahead of you. You cannot begin to anticipate. But may God's love and guidance and peace be real to you every step, to you and your children, every step of the way. Whether it's El Cinco de Mayo or any day of the year, so may it be. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm happy to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Alan William Ruff. Thank you. tell you that there will be a receiving line at the reception, and you may receive there at your leisure. Thank you.